Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Now we shall study about the subject of school, community and teacher. It is lecture number 27 and the topic of today's lecture is co-curricular activities. Of lectures are introduction about co-curricular activities, concept of co-curricular activities, types of co-curricular activities and need and importance of co-curricular activities in educational process. First of all, we introduce that what is the concept of co-curricular activities. Co-curricular refer to activities, programs and learning experiences that complement in some way what students are learning in school, that is experiences that are connected to or mirror the academic curriculum. Co-curricular activities are typically but not always defined by their separation from academic courses. Co-curricular activities facilitate the development of various domains of mind and personality, such as intellectual development, emotional development, social development, moral development, and aesthetic development. Creativity, enthusiasm, and energetic positive thinking are some of the facts of personality development and the outcomes of extracurricular activities. Moreover, if we see the concept of curricular activities, so co-curricular activities, earlier known as extracurricular activities. These are the components of non-academic curriculum that helps to develop various facets of the personality development of the child and students. For all-round development of the child, there is a need for emotional, physical, spiritual and moral development that is complemented and supplemented by co-curricular activities. Co-curricular activities are defined as the activities that enable to supplement and complement the curricular or main syllabi activities. These are a very important part and parcel of educational institutions to develop the student's personality as well as to strengthen classroom learning. Co-curricular activities were mainly organized after school hours and so were the extracurricular, but they are not an integral part of the activities of the school as its curricular work. So according to Agrawal, this is 2000. Then according to Bhatia in 1996, co-curricular activities may be defined as the activities undertaken to strengthen the classroom learning as well as the other activities both inside and outside the classroom to develop personality of the child. So this is saying of what the Bhatia. Again, Mittal in 1999, this was said that various social and other types of activities like literary, dramatic, social services, etc. So which attracted the attention of the child were considered as extracurricular activities. So extracurricular activities have been renamed by educationists as co-curricular, which implies that all these activities are part of a school curriculum. The sum of total all activities planned directly to reinforce the curriculum in those spheres of learning where otherwise it is difficult to teach within classroom. Moreover, the concept of co-curricular activities are that these are the activities through which a learner explores one's abilities, develops the strengths and eradicates the shortcoming through informal guidance, observation and self-assessment. So there are different types of co-curricular activities. Co-curricular activities can be categorized into the following headings, like
literary activities, physical development activities, aesthetic and cultural development activities, civic development activities, social welfare activities, leisure time activities, pleasure trip activities. There are some other examples and types of co-curricular activities like sports, musical activities, debate, model, art, music, drama, debate and discussion, declamation contest, story writing competition, essay writing competition, art craft, recitation competition, wall magazine decoration, write-ups for school magazine, folk songs, folk dance, flower show, school decoration, sculpture making, fancy dress competition, preparation of chart and models, album making, photography, clay modeling, toy making, soap making, basket making, organization exhibitions, and celebration of festivals. So number of co-curricular activities are there that may be indoor and outdoor activities. So in detail, if we discuss that what are the literary activities. So in literary activities, it includes debates and discussion quiz, competitions, library, literary club, poetry, etc. And in physical development activities, what are the types of activities that comes under physical development? That is games, sports, athletics, mock drill, parade, scouting, hiking, and NCC. NCC means National Cadet Corps. Then the other types of co-curricular activities are aesthetic and cultural development activities. And under this area, the activities includes painting, music, sculpture, handicrafts, fancy dress, dramatics, folk songs, photography, etc. And then in civic development activities, students union, cooperative store or then other types of co-curricular activities are social welfare activities. Under social welfare activities, what activities comes like working at hospitals, civil defense activities, firefighting, social services on special occasions, festivals, cultural programs, etc. Then leisure time activities. What types of leisure time activities? Stamp collecting, coin collecting, floral, photography, reading, needlework, and knitting. That includes under the leisure time activities. More types are pleasure trip activities. What type of activities are there? This includes picnics, visits to hospitals, places, museums, exhibitions, meeting personalities. That comes under pleasure trip activities. Then what are the need and importance of co-curricular activities? Here I would explain that co-curricular activities are the true and practical experiences received by students. To a greater extent, theoretical knowledge gets strengthened when a relevant co-curricular activity is organized related to the content taught in the classroom, intellectual aspects of personality are solely accomplished by the classroom. While aesthetic development, character building, spiritual growth, physical growth, moral growth, creativity are supported by co-curricular activities. Frankness and clarity in language and personality is supported by these activities. It helps to develop coordination, adjustment, speech fluency, extempore expressions. So among students both at the end as well as college level. Some other benefits and importance of co-curricular activities are like co-curricular activities stimulate playing, acting, singing, recitation, speaking, and narrating in students. In educational point of views, it has very importance. Then history like geography, nature, and observations. Then the collection of photographs, stones, flowers, player strip, etc. Then cultural diversity, we can see through tableaus, national songs. So we represent the cultural diversity. Then language and expression, and through debate, discussions, symposiums. So different languages and expressions may be seen. Creativity comes through co-curricular activities like participation in fine arts, floral, embroidery, etc. So activities like participation in games, debates, music, drama, etc. that helps in achieving the overall functioning of education. It enables the students to express themselves freely through debates. Games and sports helps to be fit and energetic to the child. It helps to develop the spirit of healthy competition. These activities guide students on how to organize and present an activity, how to develop skills, how to cooperate and coordinate in different situations. So all these helps in leadership qualities. It provides the avenues of socialization, self-identification and self-assessment when the child comes in contact with organizers. So fellow participants, teachers, people outside the school during cultural activity inculcate the values to respect others' views and feelings. It makes you perfect in decision making. It develops a sense of belongingness. And co-curricular activities provide motivation for learning. Co-curricular activities develop values like physical, psychological, ethical, academic, civic, social, aesthetics, cultural, recreational, and discipline values. You know, logic and some laws of science, science exhibitions, for example, innovate new means of producing energy to meet the energy shortfalls. In other need and importance of co-curricular activities include psychological values. Then emotional health includes sports, develop spirit that winning is not everything, but to play well is everything. Then interest or individual differences. Social development is very necessary through co-curricular activities. Physical development. Sports and games helps the students to build a strong physique. And then recreational values. Increases like hiking, trekking, etc. Now there are some effects of co-curricular activities on personality. Remember that the whole child that is comprised of cognitive, creative, emotional, social, and physical. So there is a lot of effect of co-curricular activities on personality. Co-curricular activities have a stronger impact on developing, adaptation, self-confidence, honesty, social ability, sympathetic attitudes, social obligations, sense of responsibility among male secondary school students than female secondary school students. So if we say that what is the difference between curricular and co-curricular or extracurricular activities, so curricular activities basically we consider those activities that are a part of the curriculum, and co-curricular activities are those activities that are outside but usually complementing the regular curriculum. So extracurricular activities are defined as those school-based activities that are not tied to the curriculum. So there are some tips for students to manage academic and co-curricular activities, like academic comes first while extracurricular activities is essential, but academic comes first. So but picking about extracurricular activities, manage your time, learn to prioritize, adopt a healthy lifestyle, take breaks, and get advice from the academic advisors or seniors. It includes intellectual development. Definitely, through co-curricular activities, intellectual development may be there. Physical development of the child that happens, and social development increases, and moral development of the students that increases, and emotional development also becomes stable, and aesthetic development, this is also very necessary for spending the life. Then there are some advantages of co-curricular activities. We know that everything has some advantages or disadvantages. So here we will see that what are the advantages of co-curricular activities. Co-curricular activities fuel your learning by stimulating creative thoughts, improving your social and organizational skills, developing your interest and talents, and offering you the chance to switch off and do something you really enjoy. So if we have captured your imagination, so here are our picks for the top benefits of co-curricular activities in high schools. So if we talk about social skills, so this is it's easy to forget when you have got your nose buried deep in a book, but interacting with your peers, it is essential to ensuring your high school experience as is as rich as it can be. Even if you are not someone who finds social situations easy, joining a school club is the perfect way to meet like-minded individuals. Having fun with friends, which will make your high school experience more enjoyable, and those social skills will come in handy when you start university or your job first. So never underestimate the importance of connecting the others. There's a power in building networks. The friends you make tomorrow could be the ones who support you in your whole life through. So one of the advantages, body and mind coordination becomes through co-curricular activities. Physical stamina increases through this co-curricular activities. National integrity and unity comes, and ideological values and cultural values increases. Creativity, innovations, novelty, entertainment, communication skills improves, and personality development, definitely that is due to co-curricular activities, and ethics, morality and values comes through this activities. Now there are some disadvantages of co-curricular activities, like difficulties faced by the students. There are so many students that they face while performing or while participating in co-curricular activities. This may be considered, somebody says that this is totally wastage of time, and there may be a lack of concentration to study due to tiredness. The other thing is that students are too shy to participate in these activities. Students are not economically well off to bear the extra expenses. Sometimes students feel that these activities interfere with their studies. These activities are not assessed in the examination. And some other problems faced by the teachers. Teachers overburden. Teachers has lack of knowledge. And teachers are not competent to organize a sufficient number of activities. Most of the teachers consider these activities are superfluous. then limitations of the institutions are there. Like in crowded cities, it is generally not possible to have spacious playgrounds. Activities are not given in a place in a school's timetable during school hours. Then extra financial burdens. So what is the contribution of co-curricular activities in national development? So remember that Pakistan is recognized all over the world for its sports. Terrorism has tarnished the image of Pakistan internationally. Need to recognize, reorganize the educational institutions to conduct the co-curricular activities. Co-curricular activities form the correct form where the energies of the youth are directed toward the correct directions of the prosperity, unity, and pride. And if we talk about Pakistan and sport, then hockey world champion, Pakistan is an Olympic champion also, squash world champion, and wrestling world champion, kabaddi is Asian champions, cricket world champions, snooker world champions, badminton world champions. So all we have this honor to get award of our becoming a champions, boxing Asian champions, world champions. So dear students, this was all about today's lessons. For being and listening carefully, take care. Allah Hafiz.